Okay, so here we are. Now, I used a glue stick, and I have used a glue stick for most of the time I've done this because it's a dry glue, dries quickly. I don't have to just do two pages and wait for things to dry. The other things I use are Tape Runner. The new Glue Dots Tape Runner works great for this, or Elmer's Extreme School Glue. All of those dry pretty quickly and cleanly and easily, and of course the tape runners are dry to begin with, so I wouldn't use tons of matte medium or gel medium, and this is, first of all, not that kind of journal, and they take too long to dry. So here's a little flip of what I did, and really just using bits and pieces and parts, really randomly, not thinking too much about it. It takes me about an hour to do one of these little journals from beginning to end. They are a lot of fun to do, and they're a great way to use up those little bits and pieces that you have that you want to use. You're not quite sure how. You don't want to throw them away. This is a great way to use them up. These words that I was using are one of those things that I said that I printed so I could photograph them for my Etsy shop. It is a digital download, and you can print them on sticker. They're formatted to fit on a sticker sheet, or you can print them on regular printer paper. These are printed on printer paper. And some of these are like my artwork, and they're a lot of fun. My fingers got really gluey, so I did miss a few spots, so I'll just go in here and do that. Might come across anything that's sticking up. I like Yoohoo. It sticks pretty well. I don't have a problem with it lifting or anything like that. Of course, you know, if you're not a glue stick fan, then use Tape Runner or something like that. That would work really well. And, you know, this just goes to show, for those of you who think that when you send me happy mail that I don't save it, I don't use it, I probably just throw it away. I do not. I save it. I have piles and piles of it, and I use it. I'm going to be sitting tonight and going through some of my old Flow magazines, I think, and trying to get some images out of them. There's another, oops, the part I missed. So this is a lot of fun to make an interesting journal without, you know, there's no paint involved unless, of course, you want there to be. You can, of course, stencil or paint on the pages, do something inky on the pages, doodle on the pages. You don't have to. It could be strictly a glue book, like this one is strictly a glue book. Sometimes I do these and then I go back and later and add doodles or stencils or something to them. I don't always. So there you go, all the way to the end. So that's it. I hope it gives you some ideas of what you can do either in a small little junk journal you have or you were given, or you could, of course, do this in any small journal that you have in your stash. You could use a little moleskin or a mini composition book, anything. It's just about using up what you have in your stash and creating something interesting with it. So I hope it gives you some ideas of what you can do. Go check out Cindy's video, and I'm going to link Shannon Green's channel too. For those of you who don't know who Shannon Green is, she has a number of journal making videos on how to make journals themselves, how to do these type of glue book journals, and she has one that's called Journaling by Fives. Those of you who don't know and have never heard of it before, you might want to check out. So I'll link her channel below. Go check her out. That's it for right now. Please like, share, and subscribe. And if you can, support my channel by shopping over in my Etsy shop. The link is in the description below. You can also join one or both of my Facebook groups. Again, the links are in the description below. And the most important thing, though, go out and have a great day and do something nice for yourself because you deserve it. Like maybe work in a little journal, a little glue book. That's it for today. I'll see you later. Bye, guys.